Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another tutorial video. Going to continue working with our Dark Eldar Mandrake here. Basically what we're going to do today are the pants of our model. Now, I've done kind of khaki sort of tan colored pants in a lot of different ways over the years, but what I'm going to show you guys today is what I'm currently using. It's kind of a sloppy, sort of almost tabletop-ish way to do it, but it works pretty darn well and produces a fairly nice result. Now, basically what this requires is two colors. You're going to need medium gray from Vallejo Model Color. It's color number 111 in the States, or 987 internationally. And you're also going to need this color right here. This is Deck Tan from Vallejo Model Color, 110 in the States, and 986 internationally. Basically what we're going to do, I've already base coated this whole thing out with the medium gray. And all I'm going to do is add little bits of the Deck Tan to it until we get up to Deck Tan. Now, for this model, I'm only going to use probably three highlights. Probably, maybe four. It depends on what we're going to do. I don't know. Basically, what I've got mixed up on my palette, though, is a 2-to-1 combination. Two parts of the medium gray and one part of the Deck Tan. So we're going to come in. And I'm going to show you exactly what to do here. I'm going to utilize the back of the miniature. That way we'll get a lot more highlight area. This front part of the model would be nice, but it's in such shadow. I mean, you can see when I just hold it there underneath the light how much of it is actually shadowed. It's just not really a good area to do a tutorial on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do these back few little areas. We'll see how fast we can blitz through this, and then I'll repeat the process on the front up here off camera. But let's do this, shall we? Alright, so I've got my highlight mixed up, 2-to-1. Basically, all I want to do is rebase coat the entire thing, except I want to leave the previous color in the deepest recesses. Alright, so this is basically going to be a rebase coat. Nice, simple technique. Now, I've got this thinned out, although I don't have it thinned out a lot. It's probably, I honestly can't really tell you how thick it is. You know, I used to read tutorials and books and things that say, you know, thin your paint to the consistency of milk. Well, I don't know what the consistency of milk is. So, I'll tell you this. How about this? Thin your paint till it flows off the brush nice and easily. That's about all I can give you. If we go thinner than this, I can show you specifically how to thin your paint. But it's kind of difficult to demonstrate when really all you're looking for is for the paint to come off the brush. Alright, again, all I'm doing is applying this on the pretty much the entire thing except for the deep cracks and crevices. Alright, and we'll do, I tell you what, I won't do the legs here, but I'll do everything else. Let's do all these lower areas because I want to get something other than just, you know, up and down vertical lines. I'd like to get this little triangle in here and probably maybe this little triangle piece in the leg over here just to give it a little bit more contrast and to give you guys a better lesson as to what to paint on certain details. So what we'll do is we'll just hit everything like that, but we'll avoid the upper leg and that kind of thing. So just gently want to just bring this color in like this. And again, really, just covering up everything except the deepest recesses. Okay. And if this color, you know, after you base coat, if the color that you're highlighting with doesn't cover the base coat entirely, that's okay. If your base coat shines through just a little bit, you can actually create almost a sort of a pseudo third color. You know, what I'm adding here is a highlight color, but if the base color kind of comes through just a tiny, tiny bit, not a lot necessarily, it sort of creates the illusion that you've added more colors to the model than you really, really have. But that is a lesson for another day, because that's a much more complex lesson on how to do that, and one that this model doesn't really warrant. It's a good model, but it's not one that I want to put a ton of amount of time in. I do want to do my best on it, but I've got other models that I enjoy or that I think I will enjoy painting far more than this one. So we'll do what we can here, and then progress elsewhere. Alright. So, well, I'll tell you what. Do I want to do that part up there? No, I don't. I really don't. So what I'm going to do there is just utilize the lower leg on this side. So you can kind of, this will actually be kind of good because you'll have a good contrast with the upper areas of the legs and then the lower areas of the legs down here. That'll work nicely. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take my current color, that right there, and all I'm going to do is add a little bit more of this deck tan to it. And although it doesn't technically give us a true one-to-one ratio, I mean, we started out with 2 drops of the medium gray, and now we have 2 drops of the deck tan, it doesn't really give us a true one-to-one because we've already utilized some of the paint. Now, how quickly you paint depends on how much of that paint that you've utilized. So you might, if you're a slower painter, you might actually want to mix up a one-to-one mixture of this stuff, but I'm just going to mix in another drop of deck tan, and because I painted most of the area that I was going to paint fairly quickly, I think we'll be okay in having this be as close to a one-to-one mixture as we can get. So, let's set that mixing brush to the side, figure out what the hell that is on my paper towel. I think it's a piece of dried paint. It looked like a bug. See that? That's something you don't want to see show up on your plate or your desk right next to your fingers or your arms. Little creepy, but let's move forward, shall we? So I'm going to take my same brush. By the way, this is a Winsor & Newton Series 7 single zero brush. I usually don't go too much smaller than this. This is a good detail brush. Normally I would use a size 1 brush, but my size 1 brush is a little on the frayed side right now. It's not necessarily frayed, but the tip is much, much larger than it should be. It's kind of lost its point a little bit, so that's all right. We shall utilize the single zero, and we'll be just fine. But I've got some of this in my brush now. What I want to do, I guess I should take it out of the brush and explain to you what I'm going to do, first of all. All right, so see how we're going to explain this. Okay, I need something to draw on. Something preferably I haven't drawn on before. Not that. Alright, hang on. This is called being prepared. It's not something I'm good at. Okay, here we go, this'll work. Alright, now I need a pen. Oh, here's a pencil. Ha ha ha, trusty pencil I always keep next to my desk. Alright. So, let's see, where's my pencil? There it is. Okay, so, let's say that we have a cloak, and it's coming off the miniature here. So, like, here's the model's head, and here's his body, or most of it, and there's his feet, and there's his arms, and I don't know why it looks like he's got hair, but we don't want to do that, do we? We don't, no. See, this is why I'm a painter and not a drawing person, because this is about the extent of my drawing ability. All right, so he's got 2 arms. He's got 2 legs for the most part, and then he's got, let's say, this cape coming off of him. All right. We'll pretend it's a cape for now so that you can understand the lesson. Okay. You got sunlight up here shining down. Okay. Now, as this angle flattens out, in other words, as this changes and becomes like that, okay, so as it kind of sweeps outwards and becomes more parallel with the horizontal, that portion gets more sunlight. So in this case, if the leg or if the pants sweep out this way, the sun hits here. Technically, this is closest to the sun, but because the angle is more vertical than this angle down here, this angle down here gets more light. And so you put more light down here than you do up here. Makes sense? Hope so, because we're moving on. Alright, if it doesn't make sense, feel free to leave a comment and say, Christopher, I need help. And I may or may not help you. It depends on how many people need help. I need help. I need mental help. Alright, let's get started. Well, let's continue, because we already started a while back. All right, so as we look at the miniature here, We can take that same concept and apply it to the model, and what you end up with is something that will kind of look like this. Alright, so we leave the previous color kind of towards the top, and we highlight towards the bottom. Now, what I'm going to do, you see the recess right there, the fold in the cloak, I'm not going to paint the underside of the fold right there, because that's going to receive less light, and because it receives less light, it's obviously not going to be highlighted as much as, say, the top of the fold, which would receive a nice amount of light. Okay, so we're just going to apply this color very gently towards the lower portion of the pants. And it's very quick. I mean, once you get the hang of where to put the highlights and stuff like that, this type of painting goes very, very quickly. You know, I have to slow down here when I show you guys, A, because I want to make sure that I'm explaining myself correctly, but I also want to make sure that I'm in frame and you guys can see everything and that it looks nice for the camera. But for the most part, very, very easy stuff to do. Okay, so there we go. There's highlight number two. And you can see how different that looks than the area above it. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to add another color of deck tan, another drop of this deck tan to our puddle of paint. And I'm going to mix it together. And this will give us essentially a 3-to-2 highlight ratio, with deck tan being the master color, i.e. the 3, not the 2. Alright, so let's pick up a little bit more of this. Okay, and we'll do the exact same thing that we just did, but we'll shrink the area down even further. So in other words, we'll go even further down the pants. Alright, so we'll do something like that, and then pull that highlight down just slightly. Maybe a little bit down there. And then we'll do that to kind of create a little contrast area there. And then we'll come down there, and right here-ish, maybe there. And then kind of come around that little hole right there, pick up some more paint in the brush. And then we'll do this. And then touch that area up there and that area up there. And then we'll kind of bring this highlight this way a little bit, not too much. There we go. All right. Nice and simple. Okay. Now we're going to add, what do I want to add? Let's see, 4-to-2 would be the same. Oh, okay, yeah, that's exactly what I want to do. All right, so the next highlight is going to be 2-to-1. So we're exactly where we started, only the ratio is reversed this time. Now, instead of having 2 drops of medium gray and 1 drop of deck tan, we now have 2 drops of deck tan, 1 drop of medium gray, and I'm going to achieve that by adding another drop of deck tan to my mix, which will essentially give me 4 drops of deck tan, 2 drops of medium gray that we started with originally, which creates a 2-to-1 ratio. Only it's reversed from where it was when we started, which was, you know, 2 drops of the medium gray and 1 of the deck tan. So we're exactly backwards from where we were, which is a good place to be. All right, and then what we'll do after this is probably just put on one, just straight out of the bottle shot of deck tan, and call it a day. All right, so we're gonna do the same thing here: a little highlight there, a little highlight down here. Okay, kind of like that, a little bit here maybe. Oh, and then let's do this here, and then that right there. And let's do this here. This piece here, and here. Down there. And then we'll do this piece. And we'll highlight that, and kind of hit that area too. And maybe pull that highlight down this side of the leg just a little bit. And there we go. You can see how quickly this goes once you really start working with it. And then all I'm going to do is I'm going to take some deck tan straight out of the bottle. And we're going to thin it down with some water so it flows nicely. And we're just going to apply it to the model. Alright, so let's do this. And then right there, and then maybe a little bit there. Tiny bit there. A little bit there. Just putting little small areas of paint down. Now, you can modify this if you want to go and be a little bit more, if you want the highlights to be brighter, let's say, or if you want a smoother transition from one color to the next, or if you want just a lot more highlights on here, if you want there to be a much larger contrast, what you can do is you can increase the number of steps between point A here and point B. All right, remember we started out with a base coat of this right here, the medium gray. We ended with this color right here, deck tan. So you've got your point A, you've got your point B. All you got to do if you want a smoother transition is increase the number of steps from this to this. Okay, that's all it is. Now, what I will do is muddy this up a bit, because if you look at the, well, if I recall correctly, I guess I should say, because I don't have the box here anymore. I think the box showed that these guys had kind of splotchy khaki pants. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little Devlin mud here. And we're just going to muddy this up a little bit. So I'm going to swirl this around. These washes from GW, they work really well, but if you shake them up, you get a lot of air bubbles. So it's better to get the pigment mixed up by doing this. You don't get the air bubbles, and it works just as well. So just kind of swirling it around like this. All right, and we'll pop the top. And this time I will switch over to my size 1 brush because I want something that can cover a larger area slightly more quickly. And I'm just going to dip some of this out onto my palette. Not a lot of it, preferably. Okay. I'm going to go maybe 4 scoops. I think that should be enough, especially after I water it down. So let's see, where's my thing? There it is. All right, so we got our color there. I'm going to dip my brush in my water cup, kind of tap it a little bit, and then just mix that drop of water that's on my brush into this blob of Devlin mud that's on my palette. And I'm just going to kind of load the brush up like it is. No big deal. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my paper towel. I'm going to gently touch the area next to the ferrule to the paper towel. The capillary action of the water will pull the water out of the brush, leaving me mostly pigment in the brush with a little bit of water. And all I'm going to do is just apply this kind of sloppily over this area. And it will give us sort of a splotchy, kind of dirty effect. Alright, I need a little bit more of this, and I'll go backwards from this side towards the other side again. Okay, very gently. There we go. Just like that. And I'll just let that dry like that. And that should give us a really, really nice kind of muddy effect. So join me in just 1 second. I'll let this dry. I'll go ahead and do the rest of the model as well. And once it's dry, come back in and I'll show you exactly how it looks. And as you can see, we are back and we've got the entire thing finished now. So looks pretty darn good. Very similar to what's on the front of the box cover art for this particular set of models. Just sort of a splotchy, kind of partially dirty khaki look is really all we're going for. You know, as I was doing the rest of it, I thought, you know, for these mandrakes, how interesting would it be if you took the same concept right here, and instead of having it be like a khaki, dirty kind of a color, why not make it like a flesh tone? I think it's sort of a dirty flesh, so it almost looks like they're clothing is made out of a skin of, say, an Eldar or an Imperial Guardsman or something like that. A little morbid, but kind of an interesting way to look at it, especially for these dark Eldars who, I mean, you know, who knows what kind of debauchery they're involved in. But anyway, that's how I did the pants on my guy to sort of make it look like the one on the cover art. Ordinarily, I wouldn't add in the Devil in Mud wash. I would just go right with the khaki stuff. Or not the khaki stuff, the medium gray, the deck tan. Maybe even highlighting up to an ivory. Or adding a little white to the deck tan to kind of make it pop a little bit further. Maybe adding a little bit of darker color in this front area down here where you don't get a lot of light, where it's good, some good shadows and things like that. But overall, I think it turned out quite nicely as far as looking similar to the box art. So what we'll do now is we'll move on to the next portion of the miniature, which my guess would be is probably going to end up being the sword. I think I'll save the flame for last. And yeah, so that's going to be it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned a lot. If you have any comments or questions, drop those down in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you have not already done so. Again, I want to thank you very, very much for watching. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.